here with our Honorable State Representative, Ms. Latoya Greenwood. She's here first cameo appearance since her election.
Well, thank you.
Ms. Greenwood, so what do you think about this? What are your thoughts on this swearing in ceremony?
I am so happy to be here to celebrate this moment with Councilman Easter and newly elected Councilman Roy Minkins, and just to be here to say congratulations and to support in any way that I can.
So anything you want to say to the citizens, since this is your first time on camera,
yes,
since your election?
I would like my citizens to know that I am always accessible to you. You can reach out to me by email or phone, and to also follow me on Facebook, State Rep Latoya Greenwood. So.
Now, would you say she's accessible? That's true. I was just at a conference this weekend, and they wanted us to demonstrate advocacy and how you call them a state rep and a senator. So they used me as an example, and Representative Greenwood gave me a number. She allowed me to call her and talk to her about House Bill, and they was just overjoyed.
And I look forward to working with you on any other advocacy issues that you're concerned. I look forward to it. Thank you. And I
want to give another shout out to you, because when you call her office, leave a message, she will call you back.
Yes.
She did. So y'all wrap your arms around our representative and give her all the support you can, and let's continue to move our city forward and grow within our region. Let's we have a lovely day. Any concluding thoughts?
Nothing. Thank you. Thank you for your support. And let's go East St. Louis and the 114th District.
There you go. Back to you, Doug.
Walter C. Brandon, Associate Judge,
Oh,
Please remain standing for the invocation by Brother Reverend Jimmy Rogers.
Let us bow our heads. Gracious Lord and Heavenly Father, we humbly submit ourselves to your will. You said that men should always pray. So Lord, we look to you. No matter what the situation is, no matter what the circumstance is, or whatever the occasion, we seek your presence. So Father, now we know that as these individuals take this oath of office tonight, remind them, O Lord, that they are your servants, serving your people. And Father, we know that you are the reason they've been put in office. And Father, we thank you for these individuals who are serving your people. And Lord, we ask, O Father, that you anoint them to be the individuals, the men, the stalwarts that you are calling them to be in this day and this time. Father, we ask all these things in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
You may be seated. Thank you. Thank you, Pastor Rob. Our presiding officer for this evening was first appointed to the East St. Louis City Council in 2009. She later sought office in 2011, where she won a seat on the East St. Louis City Council. It was in 2015 that she was successful in becoming the mayor of the city of East St. Louis. She is a graduate of East St. Louis Senior High School, class of 92. And later furthered her education at the University of Illinois, Champaign, Urbana, earning a Bachelor of Arts in Accounting. In 1999, she earned a Master of Arts in Professional Counseling from Lindenwood College. The love of her life are her children and her husband. She is the very proud daughter of Colonel Jackson and the former state representative, Eddie Lee Jackson. She is a member of the Seventh-day Adventist Church in East St. Louis, where Pastor Reverend Brenton McKenzie. Would you give a warm East St. Louis welcome to your mayor of the city of East St. Louis, the Honorable Emilia Jackson McKenzie.
Should my heart feel wrong?
why he watches each one of us individually. Right? He also watches over our city. And so at this time, we're going to ask that Ms. Anita Rogers come forward with remarks.
Good evening, everyone. It is my distinct pleasure and my distinct honor to stand and share remarks on behalf of Mr. Robert Buser. I got the pleasure of getting to know Bobby as the University College Program a year to this date. He was married to my wonderful cousin Chris. And I saw a man of great integrity, a man of compassion, a man of character. Even in that trying time, I saw a man still hold the heart of his city in his hand. And he tried to take care of her and make sure that she had everything that she needed. He never once forgot about the city of East St. Louis. So I believe that it was not by happenstance that today he's been sworn in, because he does truly have the capacity, the heart, the love to make certain that the citizens of East St. Louis are taken care of. And as I said to him several times, I love you, Bobby, because you love Christine. Congratulations.
Thank you so much for that warm talk about our Councilman Robert Buser III. This time we're going to ask Ms. Brenda Rogers to come forward. Good evening. I have the pleasure and the distinct honor of introducing to some of you, most of you know him, but I have the pleasure of introducing my brother, the new councilman for the city of East St. Louis. This moment is bittersweet for us because our mother is not here. And my mother always supported him, was always in his right-hand corner. But this evening, we have to take the slack, and we have to be here for him. I thought I knew my brother, but I really didn't get to know him until he knew my students. When he became an officer in the juvenile division, I would oftentimes hear the students talking about Officer Mickens or Detective Mickens. And I did not tell them that he was my brother, because I was afraid of what they would do to me. So, after a while, the comments that they started making about him were very nice. They made me proud, because they often spoke of how he helped them, how parents would often come to him for help, and he was right there to help him. And that was a side of my brother that I had not seen, I did not know. I knew that he was helpful because he has eight sisters. And there is not one sister that has not come to him and he has not helped that sister and many other members of our family. So I knew the type of person that he was, but I had no idea what he was doing in the community. So I want you to know that when you elected him, as a councilman for the city, you elected someone of integrity. You elected someone who's going to work for you. You elected someone who is going to be his own person. He is not going to allow someone else's story to be his story. He's going to make his own story. The man that you elected for city council has been a police officer for a very long time. He's worked at several different police stations in the surrounding area. However, he first became
the type of person that wanted to be in public service when he was a young man in John Robinson Elementary School, seeking to be a patrol boy. Some of us remember what that was like to be patrol boys and patrol girls. Well, he was very proud of that, being made a patrol boy. And that set the tone for what he was to become in life. That set his tone. So moving forward, he did his many years as a police officer, and now he's decided to enter another phase. And what I would say to him is that you are not an appointed official, but you are an elected official. Your job is to work for the people of this city. That's your job. And any politician, including my brother, that does not want to work for the citizens of this city, you don't need that job. So, I'm saying to my brother, in the words of Michelle Obama, don't mess this up. Make your own story, follow your own conscience, be your own guy. Do what is right by the people of this community. Congratulations, we love you, and we got your help.
Again, let's give Councilman Robert Easton a very good.
But when you serve, when you are here to serve the people, you understand that it's not just something that you do, it's a call. It's a mission. And so I'm thankful for Councilman Easter and his striving to do the work and continue, even with the trials and the death and his encounter with his wife. Thank you for being here. At this time, we're going to have the swearing in of Councilman-elect Roy Nickens.
Solemnly affirm
that I will support the Constitution of the United States.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States.
The Constitution of the State of Illinois.
The Constitution of the State of Illinois.
And the laws of the City of East St. Louis.
And the laws of the City of East St. Louis.
And that I will faithfully discharge the duties.
And that I will faithfully discharge the duties
of councilman.
Of
councilman.
For the City of East St. Louis, Illinois.
For the City of East St. Louis,
Illinois.
According to the best of my ability.
So help me God.
Thank you. I do want to say thank you to all those who supported me over the years and this campaign. And I'm reminded once again, Levon, it's not about the journey, it's about the destination. But this journey is a different journey for me, as she stated, as Anita stated, you know, it was a little rough. There were sometimes, you know, times when you want to give up, you want to quit. You don't want to go on. When you have those prayer wars, those ancestors that's praying for you, they know that you're all right, they know that you're here for a different reason. And I just want to say thank you to all those there. We had many conversations. Councilman Greenwood, Councilman Moses, City Matt, Bishop, I appreciate everything that you guys, all the prayers and all that, to have me stand here strong today. Without you, I can do it alone. I don't have to say something. Don't have to say anything else. All right? My daughter who stood here for me today, I appreciate you, baby girl. I love you. Once again, you know, I'm thankful and I'm humbled that the citizens of East St. Louis chose me to stand here again today. And it's my deepest desire that I will do everything I can to uplift the city and bring the city, once again, that all-American city that the mayor and the rest of the council, city employees, police, when I see my boys, I appreciate you guys, all the hard work that you do. So, I won't prolong the program, but again, I just want to say thank you, and I appreciate you. Thank you.
The adventure of life is to learn. The purpose of life is to grow. The nature of life is to change. The challenge of life is to overcome. The essence of life is to care. The secret of life is to dare. The spice of life is to refrain. The beauty of life is to give. And the opportunity of life is to serve. Good evening. Oh, now, come on, y'all. Y'all got to do better than that. Good evening. We celebrate two individuals this evening who have been afforded the opportunity to serve. And let me tell you, although it looks a little empty, but people have come from far and near to witness what has just taken place, this oath of office. We have Illinois House of Representatives, the Honorable Latoya Greenwood, represent the 114th District. Then we have East St. Louis elected officials, the Honorable Doreen C. Guzman, the City Clerk. The Honorable Roy Mosley, Sr., East St. Louis City Council. St. Louis City Manager Courtney Logan Esquire. And joining us is the East St. Louis Township Supervisor-elect and former East St. Louis Mayor Alvin L. Park Jr. Other township officials, are you here? Thank you. Thank you so much.
this time, we will have our benediction by Bishop Henry Phillips.
Let us stand on our feet. And one more time, let's give a round of applause for our new elected officials and the people of the city of Chicago. We salute you and we pray Godspeed. I want you to bow your heads and close your eyes and let us pray. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for this time in life, and this time in the season of East St. Louis. Father, this is not by accident, but by chance. The people have voted and they have made their decision. They have voted for someone to represent, not political sides, but to represent their values, to represent their vision, and to lead this community to victory. And so, Father, I pray right now that these gentlemen will move toward being true servants, that they will daily seek for your guidance, your wisdom. And God, when they come together, let them come together in the spirit of unity, the spirit of wisdom, and the spirit of integrity. Father, we pray for this city that is so filled with promises. We pray for the mayor of this city, Mayor Hicks. Father, we ask that you would bring such a united force together that, God, we will begin to make new history in the city of East St. Louis. And we just serve notice by faith that we let the enemy know that yesterday is over. And we have declared that all things have passed away and all is about to become new in this city. And we thank you for new victories. We thank you for new accomplishments. We thank you for your blessings. We ask that as we now depart from this place, never from your presence, keep us from all hurt, harm, and danger. We rebuke accidents and 911 calls. Thank you for this city, East St. Louis. In Jesus' name, everyone say amen.
Amen.
Let's get lit, friends. Let's get Mickens in.